What makes a good party from 19 what?
1950.
Oh, fuck yeah. Pop that on. Fuck the planets. I want to hear what makes a good party. Ah, what makes a good party? No Negroes. Unless they're serving. Ah, this is going to be all about how women suck dick and can't fucking put a good party together.
1950.
Hello, Eileen. This is Jean. I just had a letter from my brother, and guess what? He's bringing his roommate home from college.
Oh, his roommate. Uh-oh.
Oh, shit.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
They're buying a house together.
He's gay.
Help me plan it.
I'd bang the shit out of that 50s bitch right there.
This is one party that just has to turn out right.
Yeah.
Well, the purpose of a party is to have fun together.
That's right.
And a successful party needs planning and skill.
It certainly does. And
whether
she doesn't have it, but she has a vagina.
Designed for gay entertainment.
Gay!
Oh, pause that.
That's what it meant, happy.
Yes, I'm available.
Yeah, I love a good party that is a gay environment.
Maybe they were just open back then.
No.
The brother with the roommate, a party, a gay party. Gay time.
The best part of that is visual. They're showing a gay party, and there's what seems to be giant salamis hanging. They're those big balloons that blow up but get long when you blow them up. So it's a gay party.
Oh, that's the gay entertainment. What they're saying is while your guests are mingling, you have all the queers go into the kitchen and fuck each other with salami so they don't bother you.
Yes.
That's what he's trying to say.
It's 1950. Of course that's what they're saying.
Get their fun out of the way.
Yes.
Yeah.
Keep all cylindrical objects in the other room so the gays will go sit on them.
Let's hear how gay the party is.
All right.
And for gay entertainment... Or a game party in a home.
Oh, they're playing fucking ping pong.
A birthday party.
A holiday party.
Yay.
They all take planning. And they should all
pause
be
that.
Fun.
It's a kid eating app.
That's not a kid.
Oh, there's a kid.
That's an adult woman.
It's an adult woman with a witch hat and her hands are behind her back and there's apples hanging from the ceiling and she's trying to grab them with her. That party fucking blows.
You wouldn't go to one of these parties?
No. That's where you want to see a fucking teen rioter shooting.
I got what?
Was that me?
Yeah,
I thought
good.
It was my headphone.
When I lean on this fucking board, it does knock out mics.
There it is. Is that it? There we go.
I'm on the air.
Yeah, some woman in a witch hat at a Halloween party, obviously, and they've tied apples to strings, and she's trying to bite the apple, but of course it's on a string, so it goes to the left or right as she's trying to get it. If it was a big gay cock, and I mean happy and festive, right. So that's what they mean in 1950s. Okay, let's hear what else makes a good party. I like this. Love these old films.
A guy with his head
now,
split open.
The party
drink.
Jean, Nora, and great Eileen party. Are playing. What of its purpose?
The main blow job and a piggy mask. Steve to the game. And show him a wonderful time. Yeah,
oh,
show everyone
chicks in the bedroom.
Time. Right.
Sleepover.
Now listen, this is what we have to plan. A guest list, invitations, refreshments, and entertainment.
All right.
Now, a guest list. Who we ask?
No Negroes.
There's three of us and our dates. And I suppose we could have an extra couple and two extra girls for Jim and Steve.
Ooh. Yes.
Now, what do you
wow.
think, Nora?
Well, girls. Yeah. Well, that means I'll get two.
Yeah. Steve will get the roomie that the guy's bringing home.
Yeah, and the salami, the generous salami in the kitchen.
That's pretty cool, though, that the chick's actually thinking, like, there's going to be two guys there. That aren't part of their little fucking couple thing. And we're going to invite two whores to the party for them.
Mm-hmm.
That is pretty good. What about refreshments? I bet there's no booze whatsoever.
Yeah. Punch?
Yes. We'll get some punch.
Some pop.
We won't need any grape soda or Cheetos because the Negroes aren't coming. The 50s, boy, did they hate Negroes.
Oh, let's have Alice and Ted come. They're nice.
I'd love to go to a party.
Oh,
God, where's Alice?
Alice. Did Alice?
I would love to go to a party, Anthony.
What about Alice? Does she want to go?
Alice is wonderful. Alice, be toqueless. Oh, Alice, can you get off work from Mel's restaurant? I'd love to take you to a party. But just tell Flo not to come. She has me laughing the whole evening.
Maybe they'll serve grits and she could kiss them.
Yes, sometimes Alice will put fingers in my backside and I'll say, stow them.
This sounds great. They're like teen girls. They're laying on the bed. They have stuffed animals.
How can you tell they're teenagers?
Yeah, they're because 40 and
they could either be 16 or 40.
Stalker Channing hair.
But that was the 50s.
You don't know.
Here's what you do. If a girl
I bet a lot of guys got in trouble back then.
Yeah. If a girl looks 30 or 40 in the 50s,
she could be 16 or 17.
No, she was. She was teen. If a girl was actually 30 or 40, she looked like your grandmother.
She probably was
Rule
dead.
Of thumb.
They only lived to about 40 in the 50s.
You could tell she's kind of a teen, though.
Yeah.
How?
Yeah.
Well, she's got kind of an innocent-looking little face or cheeks. Believe me, I could tell.
With my mom's hairdo.
I notice I'm getting a little filled up. That's how I know.
That's only because she's holding a stuffed animal.
That's true. I'm a plushie.
Hit it.
Gang, Margie's lots of fun. The fellas would like her.
Margie takes it in the pooper.
Margie, what has she been doing in the 50s?
All three inputs for Margie.
Margie's lots of fun. The guys would love her. Like,
well, but you know what? The innocence of the time.
Oh, I know.
They have no idea that Margie's just sucking cock everywhere.
Yeah. Margie used a lot of drool.
Sure.
Just fucking, just fucking yanking those cocks.
Because that shit never changed, so.
No.
But they're clueless. They don't know why Margie's a lot of fun.
They think it's because Margie is a beach ball and she likes to bounce it up against the chandelier.
Yes.
Because Margie's a three-hole McGillicuddy, and they don't know what that means.
She's so popular.
She's a size queen.
Yeah.
Margie.
She loves the cock, Margie.
All right.
Back up slightly.
She could queef out Sha Na Na songs. That's why they all love her.
Her ass is going out, bah, 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 bang, dang, dang. Her ass is as big as Bowser's mouth.
Margie does a thing with ping pong balls that she learned in the Philippines. Everyone loves Margie.
Fucking Margie rules.
Yeah.
What does it mean to gargle with cum? That's what Margie does.
Yeah, they don't even know what cum is. They're like innocent with their little stuffed animals. All right, let's hear.
They're nice, and they're usually in our gang. Margie's lots of fun.
Mm-hmm.
The fellows would like her.
Oh, yeah.
That's right, Eileen. And let's ask Dot. We certainly had a wonderful time at her party last month.
Oh, I'll say.
Dot, that's our Indian friend.
We're being together, but is anyone left out? I don't think so.
Don't leave anyone out.
That's our guest list. Now, invitations.
Invitations.
Should we write? Dear Alice, would you like to come to a party at my house Saturday, March 24th?
Just fucking send an e-vite, you dumb cunt.
Why don't you call on our cell phones that don't exist for 62 years? Why don't we write a letter and invite someone to this party? Yeah. Boy, this time sucks.
I'll send the email. That's right.
They're just stupid. The cell phone was just waiting to be invented. Invent the damn thing, you dummies.
They still were barely dialing a telephone.
Yeah.
Number, please. Number, please. I watched a little movie on how they told people from AT&T how to dial a phone. And it's actually a woman saying, like, instead of picking up your handset and asking the operator to connect you with a number, you dial the phone.
Oh, wow.
And she's the same voice that they still use today. It's like, if you'd like to make a call, please hang up. It's the same fucking woman. They're still using her voice.
Why?
I don't know.
Update that
shit. And they have And they had to explain, like, this is the dial tone. Man, it's a steady tone that you'll hear. And a busy signal. This is the thing that means the thing's been off the hook too long. Hated that one.
But dialing, that's right. You know what? Dialing somebody else meant no one could listen to any of your conversations.
Yeah.
You know what fucking sexual conversations are texting each other.
Oh, yeah.
When you could pick up the phone and just call Margie the fucking hole.
Margie.
Do you know how much that must... The guys are probably jerking off like animals on
Let
the phone.
Let me tell you something, Margie.
Because there was no fucking operator listening.
No. No, they could just fucking... They would listen to everything, too, wouldn't they?
I had a party line when I was a kid.
Yeah?
Yeah, when I remember that party line. Where you know what it was called?
That was like when a bunch of people shared the wire.
You share a number, right, or no?
Yeah, you'd share like a number and... You'd lift up your phone and make a call, and you'd hear people talking.
Yeah.
What kind of invasion of privacy is that?
And you couldn't, but you couldn't, could you hang up, please? Oh, sorry.
Yeah, I've been on the phone. Yeah, I got an emergency.
Remember emergency breakthroughs?
Yeah. Yeah, they used to do that.
Emergency breakthrough.
They'd really grill you about it.
Yeah,
they wouldn't just do it right away. You'd have to call the operator and go, yeah, the line's been busy for an hour. I have an emergency breakthrough. And then the operator would just pop on the guy's call and go like, there's an emergency breakthrough. And then they'd hang up and you'd be like, what are you doing tonight?
Yeah, when your girlfriend was fighting.
Weed?
The phone is off the hook. That was the worst when you tried an emergency breakthrough, but they weren't actually on the phone. It was just off the hook.
Yeah,
they didn't want to talk to you anymore.
The hook. Yeah, the busy signal sucked, especially ones that went on for hours on end. What the fuck are you doing? It finally rang, and you're like, you'd be mad at the person. Fuck you on the phone so long.
Hey, fuck you.
My phone? No one does that anymore.
Let's hit whatever. This.
Fuck, write a letter to invite to a party.
Yes.
Yeah, let's learn more about
Alice,
what makes a good party in 1950.
Margie, make sure you bring your giant vagina and ample asshole. But look at how awful her fucking letter is. Party is fucking welcome to Snooze City.
Dullsville.
Yeah. Dear Steve, Gary, Scott, and the rest of management, would you like to come to a party?
Oh, God.
That's a terrible letter.
Handwritten. She's got to lick stamps and envelopes.
From Bob Eatman.
You got to handwrite each one, too, back then?
Yes.
Get the fuck out of here.
We could find a mimeograph machine, but...
Yes. I think that was at the Skewel. Hit it. Let's hear.
They didn't have Asians around back then. Those people take
this
jobs.
Is a white party. Believe me, if they show this party, it's going to be the whitest ass fucking party you ever done.
Party
seen.
Rules.
I know. Want to go.
Head at 8 p.m. and so on. Why bother to write? This is just an informal party. Let's just phone everyone.
Sure.
Good. We'll phone tomorrow.
Next business, refreshments.
Let's listen.
We have to feed the men. And the girls, too. Especially you.
Mouthfuls of pussy.
Yeah.
We have to feed the men. That's right, bitches. Get in the kitchen and start rattling some pots and pans. And when you're done, get in the bedroom and spread them. I loved the 50s.
And we got to get some steaks for our eyes in case we get punched.
In case we say something out of turn.
Like how huge Sammy Davis Jr. is.
go backwards.
Do you believe that twat was going to write letters when they had phones?
Yeah, they had dummies. A phone. Okay. Yeah, just phone them. Well, the phone was so new, she was probably like, oh, yeah, that thing.
Yeah. Maybe
we could think about it.
Let's go to their house and hand them the phone and tell them, hey, stupid, pick it up. Hit the buttons, cunt. Idiot.
Hit it.
We have to feed the men.
And the girls, too. Especially you.
Gee, thanks. Does it show?
Yes.
Well, we want something to eat and something to drink. Refreshment.
How about hot chocolate and sandwiches? I'll fix the sandwiches.
Well, thanks, Eileen. Suppose
I talk... Hot chocolate and sandwiches.
This party stinks.
And this is what makes a good one?
And then the bread can stick to everybody's mouth, and they'll all have bad bread breath.
No kidding.
What's worse than bread breath?
All the men's breath will smell like Margie anyway.
What the fuck?
Hot chocolate and sandwiches.
That's
for a
horrible.
Party.
That stinks.
Tomorrow we'll have hot chocolate and sandwiches.
Sandwiches.
Right. What a dull fucking party this is.
Stinks. Damn, my party.
Stinks.
Don't get nervous.
Yeah.
Don't get nervous. Hey, why don't you get him a hot chocolate? The hot chocolates are on the house. Yeah.
More hot chocolates.
Sandwiches. I'll fix the sandwiches.
Well, thanks, Eileen. Suppose I talk it over with Mother and get her suggestions.
Mother.
All right.
Now next is entertainment.
Oh.
We want to show Steve a good time, but, well, we don't know too much about what he likes.
Oh!
Yes, but more men. Yeah. Fat cock. A couple of men, Cuban men dancing.
Yes, unclipped dicks. Lot of hair.
Yeah.
Big bears.
We don't know what Steve likes. Every time he looks at a vagina, he runs to the sink and retches.
And it is so innocent. It's like everyone listening to this would make the joke like, oh, what is Steve like?
Yeah.
Steve would like to put it in your face, you dumb bitch. But
he doesn't want your stupid sandwich.
Obviously don't know.
Yeah.
We don't know what Steve likes. He just sits in meetings and makes a weird jughead face.
Oh, shit.
Wow, you went with another Steve there. The brilliance of Jim Norton.
Sandwiches is from Goodfellas, when they're in the prison scene.
Yes.
Thank you. I just want to clear that up for people.
Well, we don't know too much about what he likes. The best thing I know for breaking the ice and getting people acquainted is some good mixer games.
Oh, but they can be such a bore if you don't have good ones.
Like this whole party?
Well, let's go to the library and get some good magazines and books. And find some really good games.
Library?
Oh, good. Then this party can just be an informal, get acquainted sort of party, and we'll have games for entertainment.
Yeah.
Well, there are still many details to be planned.
These bitches don't know
shit. The basic things are settled.
Okay.
guest list, mm-hmm. invitations,
what is Steve
refreshments.
Like,
where the fuck would they show this, by the way?
We're watching on the internet.
These would be in schools. They would show them in schools.
Why
like,
in school?
Because they wanted to teach the women folk how to throw a party.
How to behave properly.
And then there would be films for guys, like, you know, hygiene, wash your dick, things like that. So you could get into fucking Margie.
When Patty was young, Patty would watch this and agree with it.
Yes. Oh, that's good. A guest list works. That's good for number one invitations. I don't have any friends, so it's zero. My phone isn't paid for, so I can't call people. Refreshments, I'm broke. Some Starbucks. I'll give them coffee, and then we could eat coffee grounds. Entertainments, I'll put on the overnight show. Creep.
Enough with her.
All these things should be planned to fit together well.
Yeah. Like Margie and a conch.
It's the big night.
Oh!
Uh-oh. The planning and preparation will help make a good party.
This is just like a compound
but
party.
What else makes a good party?
Drunken.
Oh, pause. It's the make sure there are lots of racial epithets. And drink until it's uncomfortable for everyone around you.
Leave Jell-O shot containers everywhere so you're trotting upon them for 3 or 4 days.
Take liquor and spill it all over the soundboard in clumsy fashion.
Go downstairs and sing some songs that are not appropriate for the adults to hear as you just keep drinking and drinking more whiskey. You'll have a great time at your party at the compound. It's here. Let's see how our party goes.
But party.
Not one
it's
black person.
It's the skill of the hosts skill. And the skill of the guests in making the party
skill.
Fun for everyone.
You have to have skill.
Here we are, gang.
Oh, boy.
Right in. Hi. Hi. How are you?
They'll show up at the same time.
Finally me.
Wonderful.
What?
First, getting everyone acquainted and into the spirit of the party. How's it done?
Come in here, Steve. We'll wait here for the girls to put their coats away.
Oh, she got
well, Steve, what do you think
welcome
about
to
it?
The party, Chip. Ted's in the other room. Since this party's so much fun, I had punch, but where's Sock'em?
I like the sultry voice that one woman had there. Why don't you come in here?
Hi,
she just got done smoking 18 Pall Malls, and it's fucking 8 in the morning.
Just stinky cigarette breath.
Yes.
Fucking coffee.
You know, the whole house just reeks of cigarettes.
Yeah.
Tar and nicotine dripping down the walls.
Her tartar breath.
Oh, it's horrible.
Well, Steve, what do you think of our game? What you've met of them, I mean.
Oh, they're swell. But what's this about me being the guest of honor?
Oh, that's Gene's way of keeping you quiet.
Oh, boy.
Margie and Dottie were just thrilled to think you college men would call for them.
Oh, a couple of campus bigwigs we are.
You bet your life. I think our guests are arriving.
I hope they're men. Boy, these two.
Like
are they hiding something?
Yeah, they're big wigs already because their heads are so big you can't wear a small wig.
Exactly.
I'm doing good at this party.
This is huge.
Everybody likes me.
Let me see. What do you think? Race. Race of the person that just rang the bell that's ready to
white.
Open the door.
Why are we even doing this?
All right, white.
So obviously white.
Do you think there'll be one black couple that comes in?
No.
Maybe, you know what?
No, and then they'll just stop it. They'll stop it like freeze frame and go, now there's a problem.
Yes. Make sure to nail down all of your possessions before these animals come in and steal everything.
Holy
they
shit.
Won't put it back.
Jesus.
They didn't have any of this. There'll be no black crap.
There is no integration. They will be as white and dumb looking. They're all wearing suits, ties, and jackets.
Yeah. So uncomfortable.
Yes.
Especially for a party.
A party or a fucking business meeting. This stinks.
Well, it's a fun party because they're going to have fucking sandwiches and hot chocolate. And suits.
Yeah, and play some fucking party games that they got from the library.
Yeah.
All right, let's see what happens.
Pin the cock on Margie.
I'm fucking obsessed with this now.
Start arriving. Excuse me.
More guests.
I hope you like our friend Steve.
Well, I hope they'll like me.
They will.
They will. Ah, the bitches are here.
Hello. Are we the first
one? Is that a Jew?
Here? Oh, no, Margie and Dottie are here.
Oh, hi, Gina. How you been?
Hello, Paul. I'm so glad
you're
here.
Hi.
Paul, fucking Ted.
Yeah.
Chip, they're all here.
Steve.
This party's great. Where's the hot cocoa?
It's amazing.
I love sandwiches. You got any peanuts?
peanut butter and jelly and some hot cocoa.
You're making him laugh. See, you'd be making, you'd be cracking Margie up.
I ain't being funny. I got to go in there and check on the youngsters while you're out here at the party. I'm 22 years young.
Oh, that's it, right? It's 1950. He's still a creep.
He's a college creep.
I'm still in college,
even though he's 22.
He wasn't an uncle yet. He was just Paul.
Hi, I'm Paul. I'm going to go in there and fix the crib.
Oh, that Paul's so helpful. Always wanting to help out with things having to do with the children.
Where's that big stuffed panda you were holding? I bet you I could put something under there. Looks like a tail. Make the little one grab it with her hand. Little baby hand around it.
Oh, shit.
Looks so big.
And, of course, no one notices or cares because it's the 50s.
Oh, look, Paul is bouncing the toddler on his leg, making a third leg. Yay!
Oh, that Paul. He loves the kids.
Yeah.
Eileen, this is Steve.
Hello, Steve.
Hello, Eileen. Aren't you the party planner I've heard so much about?
Well, and this is Paul Johnson, our star tackle.
Hey, just Steve. Let me take your coat.
Notice how Jean helps her guests get acquainted.
Uh-huh. Where's Margie?
Well, the party is off to a good start.
What?
Guests
just walked
are on
in.
Time.
Yeah, they're hanging out in the foyer.
And to help others fun.
Okay.
And when all the guests have arrived and have been introduced, the games begin.
Oh,
well-planned, well-chosen games.
Oh, no. What the fuck
are
games?
First, a simple get-together.
How come nobody will play my game?
What's your game, Paul?
Find the presents in the diapers. Where everybody has 10 minutes in the closet with the youngster to find things in their diapers. It's a fun game.
It sounds hilarious.
Everybody hide and seek, but I'll be in the crib, and you can't come in without notifying me.
Not even the star tackle?
He's a star tackle.
The star tackle, they had to bring that up. They're all in their suits and dresses, and now the party game is starting. I see some props. This woman's bringing out, like, these string thing. I don't know what kind of game
this is
going to be.
Some kind of dangling thing.
Are they like romper stompers?
I don't know. We'll find out here. Let's get this going here.
Yeah.
Each one may ask questions and try to guess his own identity.
Oh. Okay, hold the phone. What they're doing is they're pairing off. Guys and girls are pairing off. And they've got these strings tied around their neck. And a tag on it with, I guess, a popular person of the time or history written on it, and then they sling it around behind them so they don't so the person asking them questions can't see what the name is, and then you ask them questions to try to find out who the person is before the other person does.
Why can't they just mingle?
What a fun party game!
Just fucking mingle.
They're
gonna
do that at the compound, but every answer will be Adolf Hitler.
Yeah. We're fucking Pol Pot, really awful people.
Stalin.
What a terrible party.
It's horrible.
Oh,
let's see how
Ted
it goes,
Kaczynski.
This mixes the group well, and besides, it provides a means of choosing partners for the next game.
Oh, fucking.
Having fun together makes a party.
Yeah.
This means both hosts and guests.
What are they reading?
Yeah.
This party sucks. Someone's reading and they're writing that. They're taking
Whenever
notes.
Whenever any of the guests begin to lose interest in a game, the host should start a new game so fun together can continue.
What? What if someone else
And, of course, the guests have a part in this, too.
Oh.
I'm bored.
Each one should try to make the games fun. Each should take part in what the group is
Oh, by the way, right now, one of the guests is a little bit tipsy and he's taking shit on the glass table.
And Margie's underneath.
Yeah. They're all trying to guess who Joe DiMaggio is the answer. And he's dropping a fucking 4-foot deuce on a fucking coffee table.
Laying a giant duck down on the fucking table.
Or he's doing what I used to do. He's putting cat shit in the newspaper so that the father comes home and opens the newspaper and cat shit falls on him.
Oh, those darn kids.
Yeah. Hey, Ted, let's throw hot oil on them.
Oh, fuck. This video is...
And if some guests
goes on
forget
forever.
This...
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
No music?
Well, anyone, even another guest, can help get the entire group together again.
Yeah. Nora, Jim started that hat-making contest that you like so much. Come on.
A hat-making contest?
What? No, here's what happened. Jim got caught with his face in fucking a pair of panties in the bedroom. And like, what are you doing? He's like, oh, it's time for the hat-making contest. I'm making a hat.
Oh, what a fun game that is.
Yeah. I'm making a hat.
Yeah. This fucking, and it's from the laundry, so there's like period blood in it because they didn't have tampons.
There's a big red stain in the middle of your hat, Jim. Look like a fucking poster from the Declaration of Independence.
She's got to use her mom's Modess, and it just, the blood trickles over the side and makes it all red.
It's a hat-making contest.
Holy shit. Is that her panties or a Japanese flag on your head?
Oh, look, Steve puts his head under her skirt. Look, you're my hat. And then he licks her vagina and spits out her 1950s hair.
The star tackles hat is a Roman war helmet.
And this
college
is why,
boys helping him with.
This is why there are no Negroes. They would remove the hats and ruin everybody's fun.
Hat-making contest.
Oh, hat-making contest.
Who the fuck?
That sucks.
This is horrible.
Please, let's see what they make
please
the
go
hats
back.
On.
I just want to hear that again. That
yes, yeah.
We hear that.
She's so excited.
She is.
Contest
right.
If you like
some. Sam doesn't know how far back it is.
Entire group together again.
Nora, Jim started that hat making contest if you like so much. Come on.
Come on.
That's like,
in the end, we're going to give the prize the best hat. All right, here are your materials.
A hat-making contest?
Hands out anvils. Here's your material.
A fucking shotgun. Yeah.
Thumbtacks and hammers. The worst things for hat-making possible.
Here, I'll take the boulder.
Yeah. Here's some fucking scalding liquid. Fucking alligator clips.
This is terrible. All right, wait, you got to go back a little, because something was said there.
What was said? Just I'm here's your sure. materials.
Yeah, here's
yeah,
the
that's
materials.
All, I think. Yeah.
And in the end, we're going to give the prize the best prize. Hat. All right, here are your materials.
A hat making contest? Well, this will reveal some talent. The party is going well again.
No, it's not.
Have you noticed some of the skills of the guests that help keep the party fun for all?
No.
Let's look for others. Oh.
While everyone's making a hat, Steve is going through their purses in the coat room to support his methamphetamine habit. Steve is doing what Led Zeppelin's drummer used to do, and he's shitting into the handbags.
Look at these awful hats.
They all made hats out of fucking flappers.
Or toilet paper.
They're terrible.
Who has the reefers?
He's handing out materials. He gives one lady bed bugs, one lady toilet paper. Fucking horrible hats.
They're making hats.
All right.
Let's
see
what happens.
The guys' hats look like.
Yeah.
They're showing off their hats.
It's a professional hats.
Oh, the guys don't have to make hats.
Nah, just
the
broad.
All right, good.
Just the bitches holding up a giant mirror.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Make a hat, stupid.
Yeah.
We'll invent computers. Make a hat.
They would post this on Twitter, but, well... What? First prize goes to the college puke, I think.
Why?
What was the prize?
Because his bitch had the best hat.
What was the prize? What'd they get?
Did you ever play rhythm?
What? Oh, boy.
Rhythm. Oh, no.
Oh, boy. This is where they could use a black guy.
And by the way, they pause right now, and they say, and it says 4 hours later, and they're all just trying to coordinate clapping.
That's what they're doing. They're, like, clapping their hands and clapping on their thighs. This what went on at parties back then?
Stupid O-face. Terrible fucking party.
Terrible.
The rhythm.
Let her rip the rhythm. Uh-oh. Yeah, let me show you how that's done.
Yeah.
How'd you get laid back then?
It was impossible.
It's terrible.
It's a whole schedule.
Yeah.
They never just paired off?
No.
1, 3, 2, 7, 7, 2.
Oh, look, you're out. And then they get up and they brain her with a lamp. That's what happens if you clap wrong. Somebody gets up and takes a lamp and caves your fucking head in like the Night Stalker. How great is that? Margie is now a crumpled pile of what could have been in the fucking corner.
Her brainer.
Her matted hair is on the bottom of the lamp.
This'll have to be covered up.
We don't have DNA, so all you have to do is say, wasn't me.
Yeah.
Fuck.
They had seen a Negro in the neighborhood earlier that evening.
Six, but you need to know, as long as you got it for a call.
Oh.
Or how about charades?
Oh. Ah, what is that one?
Oh, look, look what she's doing. He's got like a, he's running, it makes it look like he has a gun.
Yeah.
And then he's putting on a nurse hat and he's pretending he's falling. Like, who are you? He's like, I'm Richard Speck.
Oh, fuck.
Is that a real we really have a good one.
Oh, we have a good one.
At just the right moment.
Uh-oh, here it comes.
A fire breaks out and everyone is killed. Thank God for faulty wiring. The only way to end this party right is skin grafts for everyone. And then they have a contest who can make the most convincing face mask.
fuck Jimmy.
Those hats are actually more convincing wigs than most burn victims have.
Thank God they didn't know about flame retardant material. You know, one chair burning could take out a whole block with toxic fumes.
Yes, Steve flicked an ash on Margie's back.
Let's hear.
Is anybody hungry?
Oh.
Well, a little snack certainly is pleasant about this time of
evening.
Look,
the neighbor, Eric, has walked in. And he says, I am.
A guest is late to the party, as usual.
He heard the word hungry, and he walked in and made a meat martini. No one's ever heard of this. But even in this time, they know it's unhealthy. And these are people who eat cigarettes. Yes.
There isn't one cholesterol count under 600 in the room. Let's see what they're eating.
Ooh. Simple food,
arm in arm
style, an informal way to serve refreshments. Each one can serve himself and help the others, too.
Why? Is she a cripple? I put my cock through the bottom of the plate.
Have
a hot dog.
A little more spontaneous, unplanned fun.
You're just holding it at waist height. Here, have mine. With that rule back in the
50s. Do you
50s,
know what a creep they would think you are?
Horrified.
If you had, especially, and you said it wasn't you, but then they look at the front of your suit pants and there's hot dog crumb against it. And then know that she was telling the truth. He made a hot dog penis. He has to leave the party.
Yes.
He does that every time.
That's rude. He's a Mr. Bungle.
One time he defecated between two pieces of Pepperidge Farm White, and Bill D'Angelo watched a car run over it.
Oh, shit.
Oh. And while everyone finishes eating, a little more spontaneous, unplanned fun.
Oh,
It's called a Mickey, and you put it in the drinks of one of the girls who's been behaving flirtatiously. And then everyone puts their penises inside of her, and when she gets pregnant, you kick her in the stomach. And that's how this party ends.
There's no such thing as date rape in 1950.
You don't want to marry this pig, do you? She made a terrible hat.
He's as good as Liberace. In more ways than one. Yes.
The pendulum is swinging
the other way. Oh, my God. Jimmy cracked a fart and everyone cares. Jimmy cracked a fart and everyone cares.
Pause. This is good stuff.
Jimmy cracked a fart and cleared the room.
Where's that Jimmy? And he's had a few belts. Jimmy cracked a head and now the police are coming.
Jimmy cracked Margie and no one gives a shit because it's 1950 and men can do that.
Jimmy cracked Margie because the soup was cold. Or maybe they're saying Jimmy crapped corn, and they're looking over at the coffee table, and nobody wants to clean up his fucking his shit from earlier.
Jimmy crapped corn.
And Jimmy crapped corn, and the party is ruined.
Jimmy crapped corn, and it's everywhere. Jimmy crapped corn, and it's in Margie's hair.
You know why? Because they're all German. Jimmy crapped corn, and now we're hungry. Oh, what a terrible fucking song.
This is, and they all gathered around like it was fucking Zeppelin.
Very excited.
Yes, they're very excited about the Jimmy Crack Corn song.
It is. Yeah.
When I was young, I used to wait on Master and him display.
It's a black song.
And the bottle when he got drunk.
And the shoot. The roof can fly. Jimmy crack corn and I don't care.
Jimmy crack corn and I don't care.
Yeah. Yeah, there it is. The master's gone away. This is like a slave song.
Yes, that's what you should do. When the party is slow, sing slave ditties.
Sing slave songs. Yeah. Jimmy crack corn and I don't care. My master's gone away.
See if anybody knows, oh lordy, pick a bale of cotton.
Yeah, gonna jump down, turn around, pick a bale of cotton. Go and jump down, turn around, pick a bale of day.
Get Margie out of the bathroom. She's giving herself an abortion with a hanger. We're going to sing Wade in the Water.
Shit.
And part of a good party is knowing when to go home.
Oh,
soon after refreshments have been served.
What? Eat
now,
and run?
Let's think back. Yeah. What made this party such a good one?
You'll be
what
perfect right there. If he said, if they said, and the time went, it's time to go home, like that second a black guy had walked in and was taking his hat off, and everybody had just left.
Time to leave. Oh, they hate black people back
they
then.
They really did.
Oh, let's think back.
Yeah.
What made this party such a good one?
Planning.
What do we want to do next time? If you are going to give a party, plan that party around a purpose.
Yeah. Just go to the end. We know the recap. Just go right to the end and see the summation.
Courteously, too.
Yeah.
Thanking your host sincerely for the good time you've had.
Yeah. Yes. Thanks.
All these things help.
And then take your metal car and slam into a family of eight, because you've been doing Jameson for 4 hours.
Take your 5-ton vehicle made of solid steel with nary a safety device in it.
Knowing the worst the police will do is drive you home and tell you to sleep it off. And there's a little hair ribbon in your grill.
That little Shirley Temple curl has to go under your windshield wiper blade.
Party that's fun for all.
Yes, as long as they're white.
They all go home with blue balls.
What a waste of time.
The end.
Cornet Instructional Films. The end. That's great. The master's gone away. They love adding that in. Wow. Now I know how to throw a party. I've been making a huge faux pas, as
they
say.
You really should throw a party like this.
I should. I should actually make a black and white instructional film on how to throw a party at my house.
Yeah.
There we go.
Off
and by
this.
Black and white, I mean white. There will be one thing in common with my party.
It would be funny if that's how, and you know, it's time, you had to take this, dub in that audio, and it's time for the party to be over, and we'll just have, like, fucking your black friend walk in and take his hat off, and then everybody just walks out.
They won't leave.
Yes, and the police come in and get him.
It's time to go. Oh, God,
fucking
that was great.
Hey, man, that was hilarious. All right.